Here is a classic game show moment.
Okay, let's begin. We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Zip blank.
Oh!
The answer they gave most often is worth $500, if you match it. And the next one is $250, and the third is $100. A little slow with the dinger there, weren't you, there? Okay, three celebrities are allowed to help. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
Richard.
Zipper.
Zipper.
Yeah.
Okay, there's one.
That's an open and shut case, folks.
Charles? Zip code. Yeah. Zip code.
Brett. How about whip gun?
Zip gun.
Yeah, that's like zipper.
Okay. Here who remembered Zip Gun.
No, with the crowd she hangs out, that's what they'd say, Zip Gun.
They'd say, you got your Zip Gun.
Yeah, so she got Zip Gun, Zip Code, and Zipper. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Zip Code.
Good.
Zip Code. Okay, that's Charles' answer. Let's see if it's up there, and if so, where? First, may we see the $100 response. Zip Zap.
I like gun better than Zap.
Zip Zap. Funny, it's little with me. If you were here that day, would you have said zip zap?
In all fairness to them, they would have said zap zip. Oh, of course.
Zippity doo dah.
Thank you.
Zippity doo dah. Okay. Let's find out what's under. We're looking for zip code. Here is the $250 response. Zippity doo dah.
You just told me. I had that.
Zippity doo dah. It's an old song from a Walt Disney movie. All right. Last chance for zip code. Here is the $500 response. Zip code. What'd you say?
Why, is my husband going to be nice to me?
No more dishes, no more housework.
Exactly, how nice is he going to be? Don't answer that question. All right, now listen, you got the $500 and you're going to play for 10 times that amount now. Remember, you have to match one celebrity head-to-head. Choose one now, please, Janet.
Charles.
Gonna go with Charles.
She's okay. Gonna have cardiac arrest.
Well, Charles and she have been a winning combination before. Let's see how they do now. Ready? Here we go. Charles, write your answer to this, if you would, please. Russian blank. Russian blank. Russian blank. Okay. She's still doing her dance. Charles has finished his answer. Now, we need a response from you that you think will match Charles Nelson Reilly. Russian
roulette.
Charles, the enthusiasm from the audience leads me to believe if you don't say Russian roulette, you better leave town. Now, for $5,000, may we see your response?
We interrupt this program and give you news other than Watergate. The current champion on Match Game is $14,500. If this lady wins by turning over...
This is my show, Charles. What the heck are you doing? I'm the MC.
If I turn my card over, this lady will win 18,450 and become the new champion if my card says roulette.
Thank you.
total loss.
Thank you very much.
And we have further news. That she can possibly win another $5,550, right. Then she and the 9 children will have to go quietly home.
Now, while we're all catching our breath here, we congratulate Janet Finn and we ask you to watch this message or two of interest.
That's right.
Now, one thing I have to point out.
More great classic match game episodes coming soon to this YouTube channel.
Take a risk. Take a chance. Take a dare. Play the game of Double Dare. With the host of Double Dare, Alex Trebek.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Hi, everyone, and welcome once again to Double Dare. A new game show in which knowledge and nerve are the important factors. Factors that enable our contestants to win big cash prizes. Hope you were watching the show yesterday, because if you were, then I'm sure you remember that we had a very exciting game underway with two evenly matched players. And I'd like you to meet those contestants right now. Johnny?
First, here's our returning champion, Garry James.
How are you today, Garry?
Very good, thank you.
You should be feeling pretty proud of yourself, because so far as champion on Double Dare, you have earned $1,200 in cash, a little more in the current game, but you're trailing. Do you figure that leaves you at a big advantage?
I'm sorry, I didn't get the question.
Are you at a big disadvantage because you're trailing right now?
I don't think a big one.
No? You're a competitive guy and you're going to pull it out?
Oh, I think so.
Okay, you're not at all nervous, are you?
Not a bit.
No. Okay, that's good. Glad to hear that. That's our champion. Let's say hello to the challenger right now.
Challenging Garry James is Joel Palmer.
Hi, Joel. Joel is smiling a lot right now because although he's the challenger, he is leading. Are you usually a very competitive fellow?
I would say yes.
Are you usually a very conservative fellow?
A little bit of both.
Because so far in the match, you have been playing in a very conservative manner, both you and our champion. We are going to resolve this game very shortly, because when we left off on our last program, Joel here had $450 accumulated in the game, and Garry James, our champion, had $300 in cash. That's where things stand at the moment. A game is $500, and let me tell you folks how we play the game in case you haven't seen us yet. We show our contestants clues to a famous person, place, or thing. The clues appear on the screen one at a time, and they get easier as we go along. And the first player to buzz in with the right answer wins $50 and the right to make a dare. And with the challenger at $450 right now, he is just one correct answer away from winning the game and becoming the new champion. So good luck to you both players, and we will start off by showing our home audience the first correct answer. And I will tell you that the subject is a person. So let's look at the screen, and here comes clue number one. At age 9, he ran off with a girl and tried to support her doing tricks that Houdini had taught him. The age of 9. Clue number two. He once led an audience of 2,000 people through Manhattan looking for an available theater. Clue number three. On the radio, he said, "Who knows what evil lurks in the hearts of men? The shadow knows." Clue number four. He may be the only actor to have played King Lear from a wheelchair. Our challenger, Joe Palmer, has buzzed in, sealing Garry's booth. And Joel, if you give me the right answer right now, you're the new champion.
John Barrymore.
John Barrymore is wrong, so we close you off and we'll bring Garry James back in. Good news for you. Joel came up with an incorrect answer, so you get a look at a penalty clue. The next clue is for your eyes alone, and you'll get a free guess. A founder of the Mercury Theater, he played Brutus in its first production. Garry, your answer?
Orson Welles.
You're right. You've got another $50. You trail by 100. You're in a dare situation. You can pick up the $100 right now if you give the next clue to, or give this same clue to Joel, because he hasn't seen it. It was a penalty clue, and he doesn't come up with the right answer. If he gets the right answer, however, then he is the new champion because he will have $500. What are you going to do? You're going to take the dare?
I'm not going to dare him, no.
Okay, let's bring Joel back. Garry got the right answer, picked up $50. He is not taking the dare. The next clue was a founder of the Mercury Theater. He played Brutus in its first production. What would your answer have been with that clue?
Orson Welles.
Oh, you'd have gotten the right answer. That was it. So Garry made the right move in not taking the dare. We're going on to another subject. Let's show the home audience the right answer. And I will tell you that we're going for a thing this time. A thing. Here is clue number one. Thomas Adams invented this product while searching for a substitute for rubber. Next. Workers who collect the raw material for it must expose themselves to poisonous flies. Third clue. Early brand names include Oxheart, Fight the Red Menace, and Peerless Chips. Moving on to clue number four. In 1944, it mysteriously exploded in the mouth of a Philadelphia man. Joel Palmer's buzzer. A correct answer, and you're the new champ.
Bubblegum.
We'll accept that. Chewing gum. That's it. $500 for Joel. Garry, the right answer is chewing gum, and he got it. But you've got $350 in this game, plus the $1,200, so you're leaving us with a total of $1,550. Congratulations, Angle. Thank you for joining us on Double Dare. Joel, nice going. New champion right here, and he's going to play Beat the Spoilers for a possible $5,000 in just 1 minute from now. We had a seesaw battle for all of our last show. But finally, Joel Palmer, the challenger, came through, and you won it. You've got $500, and you have an opportunity now. Do you feel more relaxed?
Much more.
Okay, you have a chance now to pick up $5,000 as you get to face the spoilers. Here they are. And for those people in our audience who might be looking in for the very first time, I will tell you that the reason they are called spoilers is because these gentlemen earn money if they can keep you from winning the $5,000. Now, as you know, each of our spoilers is a PhD, and I would like to introduce them right now. Spoiler number one is Dr. Lee Franz. Spoiler number two is Dr. Don Noven. And spoiler number three is Dr. Ira Greenberg. Those are the spoilers. Let's close their booths right now so they cannot hear what we are saying. Now, to beat the spoilers, take a look at this board. We have here eight clues to a person, place, or thing. You've got to select four clues, give them to the spoilers, and hope that they don't come up with the right answers. Each time they miss, we pay you $100. If you can give away all four clues and we still have one spoiler who hasn't come up with the right answer, then you'll win the $5,000. Now, don't worry about the numbers up there because they're no indication as to whether the clues are easy or hard. You know that, right? And you will have four passes to use if you don't want to give a spoiler a clue, right? Let's take a look at the correct answer at the top of the board. Laverne and Shirley. And for our purposes today, that is a title. We're not dealing with individuals as such, but the title of a show. Okay, pick a clue.
My wife's birthday is the 7th, so let's start with number 7.
Male regulars on the show include Lenny, Squiggy, and Carmine, the big ragu. Now, what do you think? Do you want to give that to the spoilers, or do you want to pass? One guy is saying give it. A lot of people are saying pass.
Pretty obscure. Let's give it to him.
Okay, fine. Let's test the spoilers. Spoilers? The subject is a title. And here is the clue. Male regulars on the show include Lenny, Squiggy, and Carmine, the big ragu. We'll go to Dr. Franz first of all.
No answer.
Good. That's good news for you because you get $100, Joel. Spoiler number two, Dr. Noven. Another $100. Let's go to spoiler number three, Dr. Greenberg. Do you have an answer for me?
Sesame Street.
Sesame Street is wrong. Okay, $300 for our champion here, Joel Palmer. Pick another clue.
Number six.
The two title characters work for Shots of Milwaukee Beer Company. What do you think of that clue?
It looks too easy
for them. All right, we're going to take a pass there. You've given away a clue, and you've used one of your passes. Pick another one.
Number one.
Penny Marshall and Cindy Williams star in this spin-off of Happy Days. A lot of no's coming out of the audience.
Pass on that.
You agree? You're going to pass. Two passes. Let's go to another clue.
Number three.
One of the title characters frets a lot about never having done the dirty deed, and the other is known as a wait-for-the-wedding-night type. That's a long clue, and a lot of people are saying, give it. Okay, we'll give them that clue. Spoilers? Your next clue. One of the title characters frets a lot about never having done the dirty deed, and the other is known as a wait-for-the-wedding-night type. That's a long clue, but let's hear your answers. Dr. Franz.
Sesame Street.
That is wrong. Let's go to spoiler number two, Dr. Novin.
Maud.
Maud is incorrect. Dr. Greenberg is our third spoiler. Let's hear from him right now. Dr. Greenberg?
Greenberg.
No.
Another $300. You're up to $600. Nice going. Incorrect answers from the spoilers always mean good news for you. You have given away two clues, and you have used two passes. Pick another clue.
Number four.
The last names of the title characters are DeFazio and Feeney. You've been squeezing by the spoilers so far that...
I'll give it to him.
Okay, fine. Let's see. All you have to do is get four clues past one spoiler and you win the $5,000. Spoilers? The last names of the title characters are DeFazio and Feeney. We'll start with spoiler number one, Dr. Franz.
Laverne and Shirley.
You probably heard the awe from the audience. That means you were right. You get $100. Let's go to spoiler number two. Dr. Novin, have you got an answer?
Welcome back, Cotter.
That is wrong. Go to spoiler number three. Dr. Greenberg, your answer.
I don't know.
Fine. Well, you picked up $200 there. You now have $800. You've gotten three of the clues past at least two of the spoilers. All you have to do is give away one more clue and get an incorrect answer, and that's it. $5,000 for you. You've got two passes to help you along, so pick your next clue.
Number two.
Fonzie's appearance on the first two episodes of this television series helped bring along 50 million viewers.
Get a pass on that.
I can understand why. All right, you've used three passes. You still have one to go. You've got five and eight as possible clues.
Number five.
Okay. Its stars open every episode of this series with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, Schlemiel, Schlemazel, Hassenpfeffer Incorporated.
Give it to them.
Give it to them. Okay, you know, of course, if we can get this by one of the remaining two spoilers, you've got $5,000. All right, spoilers. Here is the clue. Its stars open every episode of this series with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, Schlemiel, Schlemazel, Hassenpfeffer Incorporated. Dr. Novin, your answer, please.
No answer.
No answer. That's $5,000 for Donald Palmer, the champion. Nice going. Great. We won't even have to go to spoiler number three. By the way, the correct answer is Laverne and Shirley. And you have done it, $5,500, total cash winning so far. And as the champ, you're going to continue in another game, and we'll get to that right after this short break. Stay tuned. Joel, as a challenger in the other booth, you did very nicely. You won your game and then went on to pick up $5,000. You have $5,500. You're now in the champion's booth, and we would like to take a moment to introduce your challenger. Johnny?
Challenging Joel Palmer is Gail Brooks.
Hi, Gail.
Hi,
champion did very nicely. Went all the way, got $5,000, and it could be your turn. Let's hear a little bit about you. You married?
Yes, I'm married. I'm a mother of three children, and I'm a former school teacher.
Former school teacher?
Former school teacher. Right now, I'm busy with my home life, and I'm currently studying French and Hebrew.
Okay, so you have varied interests. That'll pay off, probably, on Double Dare. Good luck to you.
Thanks.
You know, of course, that a game is $500, right?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to start this one off by showing our home audience the first correct answer. And while we do that, I will tell you players that the subject is a person. Here we go. First clue coming up. She once said, "You can't sit around like a cupcake asking other people to come and eat you up." Next clue. She once made an instructional record called Lessons in Love for Crescendo Records. Crescendo Records. Clue number three. The title of her third book, Outrageous Opinions, was also the name of her television show. Not getting warm? Let's go on to clue number four. Her column, Woman Alone, was syndicated in 50 newspapers and magazines. Gail Brooks, the challenger, has buzzed in. She has sealed our champion's booth. He can't see or hear what's going on right now, so Gail, give me an answer.
Eleanor Roosevelt.
Eleanor Roosevelt is wrong, so we seal you off for the time being, and we bring the champion back. Joel, Gail, the challenger, gave us an incorrect answer, so you get a look at the penalty clue. Here it is. Her editorial staff calls her the Iron Butterfly. The Iron Butterfly. Do you have an answer for me? Can you identify this person?
Dear Abby.
Dear Abby is incorrect. You have an advantage over Gail, however. She will never get a look at this clue. Let's bring her back. Still no correct answer, Gail, so you're back into it, and we want you to look at this clue. Warner Brothers paid $200,000 for the provocative title of her first book, Sex and the Single Girl, and that was Joel's buzzer. The answer, please.
Helen Gurley Brown.
You are right, for $50. Off and running once again, Joel. We're in the dare situation. Do you want to show the clue to Gail, gamble that she won't know the right answer?
No, I think at six she'd know who it is.
You think she would know it? All right, let's bring her back. Joel came up with the right answer, and he has decided not to take the dare and not to show you the clue. The right answer was Helen Gurley Brown. Right. We're going on to another subject. Here's the correct answer for you people at home. This time the subject is a person. A person. Take a look at this clue. To increase her vocabulary, each week she prints three new words on her left foot and studies them in bed at night. Next clue. Growing up, she attended 20 schools in California, New York, England, Switzerland, and France. Third clue. Her ex-husband is an Australian singer. Her current one is a Hollywood producer. Next clue. Her chums while growing up included Mia Farrow and Candice Bergen. Clue number five. At the age of 2.5, she toddled on screen in a film starring Van Johnson and Mama. Gail, the challenger.
Liza Minnelli.
Liza Minnelli is right. You have tied the game. You've got $50. You are now in a dare situation. Take a look at the next clue. Her 1965 Tony Award was for Flora, the Red Menace. That's the dare clue. Do you want to take the dare and show it to Joel?
No, he's going to know that.
He's going to know? Well, let's bring him back and find out if he would have known. Her 1965 Tony Award was for Flora, the Red Menace. That's the dare clue that Gail decided not to give you. What would your answer have been?
Liza Minnelli.
Oh, she made the right move then. The game is all tied up, $50 each. And we're going to take a break for these commercial words. And then we'll come back with lots more on Double Dare. Welcome back to Double Dare. $50 on the scoreboard for each of our players at the moment. We're in the early stages of a game. A game is $500. We're going on to another subject, and here for you folks is the correct answer. And players, the subject is a person. Look, if you will, at this first clue. This man said, "The only difference between myself and a madman is that I am not mad." Next clue, clue number two. He made a barbed wire harp for Harpo Marx. Clue number three. With Buñuel, he made the startling 1929 film Un Chien Andalou. Next clue, clue number four. This artist's first name in Spanish means savior. Moving right along, we'll go to clue number five. He leash-trained an anteater for a pet. At the very least, you'll have to admit he is an interesting man. Let's go on to clue number six. He was expelled from Madrid's Academy of Fine Arts. Clue number seven. He sports one of the longest waxed mustaches ever seen. Joel thinks he knows the answer.
Salvador Dali.
Salvador Dali is right. Okay, Joel Palmer. You've got another $50. That brings you to $100. A dare situation for you. Take a look at the next clue. Clue number eight. His crucifixion depicts a beardless, short-haired Christ on a floating cross. That is the dare clue. You've got $100. You can earn another $100 if you show Gail that clue and she doesn't come up with the right answer. You going to take the dare?
I'll take the dare.
Fine. Let's bring Gail Brooks back. Gail, Joel got the right answer. He has taken the dare. He is showing you this clue. You've got 5 seconds to look at it, and then I'll want an answer. Do you have an answer?
Yes, Salvador Dali.
You are right, and that gives you $50 for a total of $100, and the game is tied once again. Nice going. Took you a long time to get to that point, but that's all right. That buzzer means we've got to take a break for a commercial. So why don't we do that so we don't upset anyone, and then we'll come back to Double Dare. We're out of time, so hopefully we'll see you on our next show. So long, everybody.
Today's consolation prizes are, first, a Power Plus 900 hair dryer and styler with full power for faster drying, lower power and attachment to control styling from Sunbeam. And for glamorous entertaining, an at-home that can go out to parties too by Huckleberry Lights and Rich and Beautiful Sienna Nylon from DuPont. And Textan, a zip-top kit and three-fold wallet, original design from Textan, a fashion leader in small leather goods. And Presto's Fry Baby, electric deep fryer, makes French frying easy and automatic. A serving of two in a jiffy or two with Presto's Fry Baby. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Double...
The word starts with S. Can you guess it? Can't she see? It's gotta be sex. Hot sex? Sex God?
I don't know.
It's so obvious. I can't believe she can't get it.
I don't know.
Hey, let's see it. The answer is hot sun.
Whoa. Now who's the dummy?
Chain reaction. Not as easy as it looks. All new season, all new challenges. Tonight at 10, 9 Central on GSN.
So you're back into it, and we want you to look at this clue. Warner Brothers paid $200,000 for the provocative title of her first book, Sex and the...